With ADS 3.0, you can activate smart driving with just one tap. Even on busy city streets, smart navigation is already engaged. Just control the speed to change lanes. The road is complex, but as long as there's half a car's width ahead, AITO M9 can even pull off an escape maneuver. It's something we'd struggle with ourselves, and I didn't even need to press the gas lightly. It handled it all on its own. Nice. The startup maneuver here was really impressive. The traffic has formed two lines, and pedestrians are moving unpredictably. Plus, there's no traffic light at the small intersection ahead where we're turning right. Now I'm going to avoid tapping the gas and see how it handles. It's starting up on its own. ADS 3.0 can assess the behavior of other road users in just 1 to 2 seconds. For example, when it saw the motorcycle on the right, it instantly recognized that the rider was preparing to turn right, and it responded immediately. No hesitation. It's pretty smart, knowing the bike was turning and not going straight, so it confidently moved forward. It accelerated without me touching the gas at all, as it navigated around a sudden cement block and some parked cars. It used to take about a second to analyze the situation, but now it does it in just 0.1 seconds. It's a more fluid and human-like response, giving a seamless driving experience. And here's the exciting part. As the CEO mentioned at the launch, ADS 3.0 has significantly improved safety and smoothness when dodging sudden obstacles like delivery drivers. Today I encountered just that. A delivery guy came out of nowhere, and the system smoothly stopped and then quickly moved forward again. There's a lot of talk about end-to-end smart driving, but what does that really mean for users? The real value of end-to-end is a seamless driving experience from your starting point to your destination, making the journey safer, smoother, and more efficient. The system has become even more aggressive in navigating tricky situations, with a much higher success rate. As we move forward, its ability to choose the best lane has also improved a lot. For instance, it quickly identified the parked car on the right and, realizing it wouldn't move anytime soon, made an early lane change like a seasoned driver, avoiding the need to stop and wait behind the illegally parked vehicle. Now we're approaching a tricky downhill left turn, with cars parked in a chaotic mess. Here we are at a busy downtown intersection, and suddenly there's a huge barrier in the middle. In these complex scenarios, ADS 3.0 acts like a skilled driver, quickly recognizing, deciding, and acting. It's no longer just about reacting to obstacles. It's finding the fastest, safest path while navigating around pedestrians or objects in the road. Instead of sitting and waiting, it handles these situations more efficiently. It even recognizes traffic cops. Pretty cool. Right now, we're dealing with some confusing lane markings. This narrow yellow line actually marks the wrong direction. Yet the system is still able to activate smart driving here. The challenge level is high. Mixed signals, irregular parking, and no reliance on high-definition maps. In the past, ADS 20 might have disengaged in such a situation, but 3.0 continues on. Earlier, taxis waiting on the right used to be misinterpreted as a cue for a right turn, causing the system to awkwardly merge into that lane. But with 3.0, it quickly assesses the situation and makes the right decision. It spotted a parked car far ahead and immediately decided to change lanes, avoiding any confusion. So how does it handle? Well, there's a car temporarily parked ahead, and it smoothly navigates past it. The clearance on the left is really tight, but it made it. We're now entering a twisted road section. I haven't touched the gas yet, and the system is analyzing whether that blinking yellow light is a threat. In extreme situations like this, you might need to lightly press the gas pedal to boost efficiency, because the system tends to be very cautious. By tapping the gas, you can assist the system in navigating through intersections. Even the ADS system can ask for a bit of help, thanks to the Audi driver for letting me through. With ADS 3.0, you still sometimes need to tap the gas pedal, because the system can't account for every possible scenario humans face in these complex traffic situations. While the decision-making has greatly improved, human driving still excels in highly unpredictable environments. In real-world driving, human and smart driving are inseparable. While ADS 3.0 frees up your hands and feet, you still need to keep an eye on things. Like earlier, I had to tap the gas twice while merging at a tricky intersection. For regular users, it's not about how often you need to take over. It's about the safety record and the ratio of smart driving over time. The real measure is how safe you've been over the year. Not how many times you had to step in. Now let's see how well ADS 3.0 handles this twisted section of the road. Looks like it needs a bit of assistance here. Oh, there's a car merging in front of me from the left. Changing lanes to the right as per navigation. Okay, made it successfully. It could have passed without pressing the gas pedal, but it would have been slower. This might have annoyed the car behind me. So sometimes it's better to assist by pressing the gas. And with that, we've arrived at Halo Mall. The experience from start to finish has been great. Now with ADS 3.0, there's even an automatic parking feature. After you leave the car, it can park itself in the spot you choose. I'll demonstrate that in a bit. The system has also upgraded its dashboard, showing useful info like your smart driving mileage percentage. All right, I've found the parking spot. Let's try out ADS 3.0's self-parking feature. I've selected the spot. Now let's start the one-tap self-parking, putting it in park. The car will park itself automatically. The first time you use the self-parking feature, it can be a bit nerve-wracking. At this moment, it's all up to the M9. This video hasn't been sped up at all. This is exactly what AITO owners can experience with their cars. This is pretty tricky. It's calculating the best path to take. There's no one around. In the future, seeing driverless AITO cars navigating parking lots will probably become a normal sight. Oh, it's moving forward a bit more. Can you guess why? Turns out it saw a car coming from the left and politely gave way. The couple in that car looked on in amazement at the driverless AITO M9. Maybe they're intrigued now. Hey, keep your eyes on the road. Your car's still human-driven. Watch out for the traffic ahead. Look at how smoothly and confidently it parked. Just like a seasoned driver. It's that simple. And it's already locked.